Today, I'm going to talk about zirconia implants, and I'm going to compare them to titanium implants. And really, more or less, the subject of this video is zirconia, also known as ceramic implants versus titanium implants. So let's start out with the zirconia implant. First off, one of the biggest draws to zirconia or ceramic implants is that they are tooth color. That is a really big deal. A lot of people don't want things that are not natural tooth colors in their mouth, understandably so. Who wants to smile and see something that looks golden, metallic, dark, orange, black, white, silver? You know, teeth are white. So most people, surprise, surprise, want something in their mouth that is a natural tooth color. The second thing is zirconia is not a metal. Who wants metal in their mouth? I've never once had a patient come into my office and said, "Wow, I sure would love to have some metal in my mouth." There can be a lot of different reasons for that, and haha, yeah, that is pretty funny, but there's a lot of things that metal does or is that is good. And that is the reasons why we have dealt with metal in the past. First off, metal is strong, it can be thin, it won't break, it actually will bend a little bit, it has some flexibility to it, and it does not break. Some of the metals can be somewhat biocompatible. Gold is definitely more biocompatible than silver. Titanium is very biocompatible, actually. I've never seen a patient react or get allergic to a titanium implant. Some of the negative things about metal is metal conducts electricity. This is the definition itself of a metal. If you apply some sort of electricity to a metal, it will flow through the metal and it will be conducted, and that generally is considered not to be a good thing in biologic systems. When different metals come in contact with one another, one metal will actually have a higher electronic charge than the other metal. So metal can pose a challenge and can be a problem when you have different metals in the mouth. For example, if you have a gold crown and a silver filling, and then you introduce a titanium implant, there can be a flow of electricity between these different metals, and where there is a flow of electricity, there can be a magnetic field, and that magnetic field can exert its effects on biologic and human systems. So generally metal is not a good thing. If we can avoid metals in the mouth, that would be the best thing. One of the problems in the past has been that we haven't had materials that have performed well enough, so we've been forced to use metal. Zirconia, if you look, technically could arguably, be a metal, but it's not. If you look on the periodic table, if you're a chemist and you look up there and you look at zirconium, that shows up under the metal area. But the actual zirconia that we're using for implants is zirconia oxide, which is actually a white material that is not metallic. That is, when you hook it up to electricity, it does not conduct electricity. It has a neutral charge. So when you introduce zirconia into the mouth as an implant or as a crown, the zirconia will not conduct electricity, and it will also not react with other metals in the mouth. And the same is true for ceramics. Zirconia really is a specialized ceramic. That non-conductivity of the metal and the color itself of the zirconia are many of the reasons why zirconia is really something people want to use these days. as a dentist, I've been placing titanium implants for, well over 10 years. And when I first started placing implants, there was no such thing as a zirconia implant. So I placed literally thousands and thousands of titanium implants. And I watched zirconia implants come out onto the market. And most of the zirconia implants that came out onto the market within the last, say 10 years, were not really any good. And what I mean by that is they didn't heal well. The way in which crowns connected to the implants was really difficult. And for all intents and purposes, they were not good enough for practical use in the dental office. However, I will let you know that within the last 2 years, I'm very excited. Ceramic implants has come out with an implant system that really, as far as I'm concerned, heals well. It has all the conveniences and it works pretty much as well for single tooth replacement and bridges as titanium implants. And I've been placing several of the zirconia implants, and I really see a path in the future where we can probably replace most of the titanium implants if we wanted to with zirconia implants. Zirconia is a brittle material. It's a very strong material, but it does not bend. So I will list this as a con for zirconia, because in the mouth, when you bite down, you can apply a lot of pressure to things that are in the mouth, and teeth bend a little bit, metal bends a little bit, and that is a good thing. I think it's really important to at least recognize the differences in zirconia and titanium. If I'm doing a full mouth of implants where I'm going to do like a one-piece bridge of maybe 6 implants and 12 teeth on top of the implants, I still feel like that case favors titanium. I just haven't reached that comfort level to do that kind of case with zirconia. But as far as replacing single teeth and spans of teeth, my preference really is just go with zirconia. The tooth coloredness of the material is really popular, and the non-metallic properties of the implant really make it a great material to use in the mouth for dental implants. Anyway, my name is Dr. Adams, and I'm a dentist at Natural Dentist Associates in Rockville, Maryland. Just wanted to give you a little bit of insight on the issue of zirconia versus titanium implants. Thanks, and have a great day.